ओम वोगी शांत्या सुमतः सत्पाथानाम उपक्रमे यम नत्वा कृतकृत्या स्युहूतं नमामि गजाननम् सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां योगिनं विश्वनाथाख्यं अस्मत्तात् स्वरूपिणं आत्मलाभात् परं लाभं वक्तारं न कदाचन गीतार्थग्रंथकर्तारं श्रीगुरुं प्रणमाम्यहम् योऽन्तः प्रविश्य मे वाचं धृतिं बुद्धिं प्रचोदयात्। ओं नम सभाभ्य सभापतिभ्य ओ नम फ्रेंड्स वी आर गोइंग टू बी डूइंग द 41st टॉक इन द सनातन धर्म सीरीज। This is an unusual talk. It is titled My Favorite Tidbits from the Tradition. I have been coming across various Sanskrit shlokas all through my life, but some of them have impressed me so much that I want to share with you. Today I am going to share with you 7 such tidbits, Sanskrit shlokas. They are not connected. They are, each one talks about something, but they have stuck in my mind so deeply that I am very interested in telling about them. The first one, you can see this is an 8x8 chessboard. I am giving you the strategy for the movement of the knight, complete tour of the knight through all the squares of the 8x8 chessboard. And for this, there is a beautiful Sanskrit shloka. I mean, we don't know who concocted it, who did it, where, since when. It has been there in the tradition. That's why I call it, these are all my tidbits from the tradition. Katim tele kucham tutam pulim pantu chike yape. I hope you were able to see it now. कटिं तेले कुचं तूतं पुलिं पन्तु चिकेयपे चेकिटा पिलुसायीसु लयूं सियति ते सचु। इफ यू टेक दिस टू ए सैंस्क्रिट स्कॉलर ही विल नॉट फाइंड एनी वर्ड वर्थ एनी मीनिंग इन दिस। दिस आर ऑल सिंबल्स क टी ते ले कु चम इट गोज ऑन लाइक दैट। देर आर 32 syllables like this. Each syllable is a position on the chessboard. The position is marked by a symbolism. That is, you see the consonants here vertically. Ka, cha, ta, ta, pa, ya, la, sa. And horizontally you see the vowels. A, I, U, A. This formula does not distinguish between long and short vowels. Again, the A, E, U, A are written in the reverse order here. A, E, U, A. So, if you go to this square in the chessboard, so this is Ta. And this, horizontally, if you go forward, this is Te, right? And if you go here, you see, on this side it is Pa. So this is P, Pa and E, P. Like that, every square has a consonant as its symbol. So Katim Te Le Kucham Tutam means, first the knight which always goes one step this way horizontally or vertically and two steps in the other side. So vertical and horizontal, one vertical, two horizontal, or one horizontal, two vertical. So that is the movement of the knight. So ka, it starts here, ka, then t, t is here, number two, te, so te is here, number three, te, le, so you see la is here, le is here, katim te le, kucham tutam, it comes back to ku, ku is here, ku, cham, cham, six, seven, eight, it goes on like that, it goes up to the 32nd square. Katim tele kucham tutam pulim pantu chike yape pu li pa tu short vowel, that is the broken vowels or broken consonants are not counted for this formula. So pa tu chi ke ye pe. So pe is the 16. So that is 16. You can see pe is 16. Right? 16. Che kita pilu sayi su layum siyati te sichu. A shloka which contains 32 syllables, 16 in the first half and 16 in the second half. So it begins with che. So after the 16, che is 17. Yes, this is che. Because cha is here and che is there. Che. Che kita pilu saji su layum siyati te se chu. So it will end up in chu. Here, the 32nd position will end up in chu, which is here. Right? Again, you repeat this shloka because there are only 32 syllables we have exhausted, 32 squares we have exhausted. There are 32 more, but the same thing repeats. You can start from katim tele. It's a beautiful symbolism. So ka, from here you go to ka, 33. Then 34, 35 goes. Katim tele kucham tutam. So the beauty of the whole thing is this symbolism has been so beautifully arranged and the shloka so nicely set up that you can remember the knight's movement, knights two. So just like that, you can go on the tour of the knight through all the 64 squares. Katim tele kucham. I learnt it even as a boy, and of course I reveled in that excitement as a boy certainly. So that is number one. Let me go to number two. How do I go to number two? Come on. Yes. Yes. This is number two now. Okay, this is a very interesting one. It says, I should magnify it, yes. King Bhojaraja, you know, was a great Sanskrit scholar himself. He used to give a lot of puzzles to the scholars in his assembly or in his country and give them rewards. So here is the poser he proposed. Ambodhi jaladihi payodihi varanidihi varidihi. Ambodhi jaladihi payodhi rudadhi varanidhi varidihi. There are six words here. Ambodhi, jaladihi, payadihi, payodihi, rudadihi, udadihi, Varamnidhi, Varidhi, six words. All six words mean the same thing. Ocean, Samudra, Ambodhi, ocean, Jaladhi, ocean, Payodhi, ocean, Udadhi, ocean, Varamnidhi, ocean, Varidhi, ocean. Anyway, that is the richness of Sanskrit. So many words for the single concept, ocean. Ambodhi, Jaladhi, Payodhi, Udadhi, Varamnidhi, Varidhi. So Bhoja, King Bhoja, makes this poser. Whoever can make a sloka of four lines, of which this is the fourth line. Ambodhi Jaladhi, this is the fourth line. This should be the fourth line, is what he is saying. And of course, scholars are simply confused. What are we supposed to do? This means only ocean, 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 like that. How are we supposed to make any shloka with any meaning out of it and making it a worthwhile shloka? How is that? It was finally Kalidasa's turn. Kalidasa, who lived at the same time in Bhojaraja's assembly. It was Kalidasa's turn, who made a beautiful shloka. He built in a mythological imagery into the whole shloka, so it made sense. So what did he do? He produced the following shloka. Amba kupyati tavata gagane gange yamutsujyatam vidvanshan mukha kagatil mama shirasi yavachira yadhruta kopaveshat. You can see the English version here. I mean English transliterated version. Kopaveshat ashayesha vadane pratyuttaram dattavan Ambodhir Jaladhir Payodhir Udadhi Varamnidhir Varidhi. A little cultural background is necessary in order to understand the imagery behind this beautiful sloka. I mean, I can never forget the interest which it creates in the audience whenever I mention this sloka. Amba Kupyati, the goddess is so angry. Is angry. Who is saying this? The sun. What is this now? It is a conversation between Lord Shiva and his son Subramanya. So the little son, Kumara as he is called, he goes and tells his father, Shiva, Amba Kupyati, my mother is angry. Tata, hey father, Gagane Gangeya Utsrijyatam. Gagane Gangeya Utsrijyatam. I am Ganga, this Ganga, Ganges, which you are keeping on your head. Which you are keeping on your head. This is the standard symbol of Lord Shiva. Shiva always keeps the Ganges on his head. So I am Ganga, Gagane, in the sky, in the space, Utsrijyatam. Throw her out, leave her, drop her away. Because my mother is angry. You cannot have two ladies beloved to you. Amba kupyati tata gahane gange yam utsrijyatam. And then the conversation is between the father and the son. Son is Lord Subramanya. The father says, Shanmukha, he six-headed son. The Shanmukha is going to be important in the meaning of the shloka, you will see that. Vidwan Shanmukha, you are a smart boy. Ka gatir mama shirasi yavat shira yadrita. Where would she go? Ka gati. She has been on my head, mama shirasi chira yadrita. She has been on my head. I'm holding her on my head for a long time. Where will she go? Ka gati. Kopa aveshat ashesha vadanaihi pratyuttaram dattavan. The little boy is freezing with anger. Kopa aveshat ashesha vadanaihi. Remember, he has six heads. Subramanya, he says, Shanmukha. That is why he called him Shanmukha. అశేషవదనయే ఈచ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ హెడ్ ప్రత్యుత్తరం దత్తవాన్ రిప్లైస్ జస్ట్ లైక్ దట్ ఈచ్ హెడ్ స్పీక్స్ అంబోధి జలధి పయోధి ఉదధి వరాంనిధి వారిధి ది ఫాదర్ ఇస్ ఆస్కింగ్ వేర్ షల్ వి గో వేర్ కెన్ ఐ డ్రాప్ హర్ ఇన్ ది ఓషన్ ఇన్ ది ఓషన్ ఇన్ ది ఓషన్ ఎవ్రీ హెడ్ ఎవ్రీ ఫేస్ ఈస్ ఆన్సరింగ్ దట్ దట్ ఈస్ దిస్ బ్యూటిఫుల్ శ్లోక దిస్ mythological imagery is Kalidasa's concoction, but it's a beautiful shloka. Amba kutpati tata gagane gangeya mutsrijyatam vidvan shanmukha kagatihi mama sharasi yavachira yadhrita kopavesha. I mean, he's freezing with anger. Asesha vadanaihi pratyuttaram dattavan. Every one of his face gives the reply, Ambodhi, Jaladhi, Payodhi, Udadhi, Varamnidhi, Varidhi. So ocean meaning word, the word meaning ocean comes 6 times, but it has been used in the shloka beautifully. Beautifully. So then we will go to the next. I will show you the next. Yeah. The next one, you see, just the one that I told you requires for its understanding a lot of cultural background. So, in fact, you know, one of my talks in a Western audience, it was very difficult to convince them that previous shloka, because you have to know about Ganges. Sitting on Lord's head, Subramanya is the sun, Subramanya has 6 heads, all those things, you see. So, here is another shloka of the same type, but very simple, naive. You know, Bhojaraja used to give rewards to scholars who bring in great compositions. Good compositions. So, 4 Brahmins, poor Brahmins, they wanted to compose a shloka worthy of reward from Bhojaraja and take it to him. But they were so poor and so much, I mean, they had no talent for poetry. What will they do? They thought and thought and thought. They debated among themselves. So instead of collectively doing something, each one tried something. So the first one found out, after all, we are going to Bhojaraja for, a kind of a reward which will remove our poverty. So we want food. So Bhojanam. So he said, Bhojanam. Dehi Rajendra. Rajendra, a lord of kings, great king, Dehi, please give us Bhojanam, food. That is all what he was able to do. Bhojanam Dehi Rajendra. And then the second one simply added to it. After all, Bhojanam must include some niceties, sweets. Grita Supa Samanvitam. Grita is ghee. You know, ghee is very sacred, very important for sumptuous food, particularly for a Brahmin feeding. Grita Supa Samanvitam. Supa is sweet meat, appam as it is called in Tamil. Grita Supa Samanvitam. So, Bhojanam Dehi Rajendra, he, O King, give us food. Grita Supa Samanvitam, which should be together with ghee and sweet meal, soup. More than that, they could not do anything. More than that. They tried and tried. They could not do anything. So, only half the shloka has been done. They did not know what to do. That was the time when Kalidasa was going. He saw them. Hey, what are you doing there? What are you talking about? And these Brahmins decided to confess to him what they were doing. So they told him, we tried and tried to compose a good shloka, just as you do very often and get rewards from Bhojaraja. So can we not make one? And they said, we have done half the shloka, but the other half we are not able to complete. Can you help us? Kalidasa understood the game. He asked them, tell me what you have done so far. Your half shloka, you tell me. So they said, Bhojanam Dehi Rajendra Grita Surupa Samanvitam. Kalidasa saw the naivety in the whole thing. And he said, okay, I will write the remaining portion, take it to the king. So he wrote there, Mahisham Chasarat Chandra Chandrika Adavalam Dadhi. Of course, these poor Brahmins didn't even understand the greatness of the other two lines, other half. But it means, you see, after all, they are asking for food. So he added, you have added Grita Supa Samanvitam, you have added ghee, you have added sweet meat, supa. I will add dadhi, curd. Without curd, no Brahmin food is complete. So dadhi. But the fact is, Kalidasa cannot but use beautiful analogies. Upama, upama Kalidasasya. So he has described the dadhi so well that all his poetic talent, all the poetry in the shloka is centered here. Mahisham chasarat chandra chandrika davalam dadhi. Dadhi, the curd has to be white, davala. How white? Chandrika davalam, white like moonlight. What kind of moonlight? Sharat chandra chandrika davalam. Sharat chandra chandrika davalam. Sharat is autumn, chandra is moon. Moon in the autumn season, that moonlight will be very bright. No clouds, no nothing. So davala, like the whiteness of the dahi, curd, should be that kind. The moonlight, of the moonlight kind, that moonlight of the autumnal moon. Not only that, mahisham cha. The taste of the dahi, curd, usually is greatest when it is a buffalo milk. Mahisham. From Mahisha, it has to come from a buffalo. So a buffalo milk, a dahi curd produced from buffalo milk and whiteness beating the chandrika, the moonlight of the autumnal moon. So this is what he gave. They went to the lord, the king, and recited the shloka with great pomp and pride. Bhojaraja was himself a good scholar. He saw the foolishness of the first half and the greatness in the second half. He immediately recognized who must have contributed the second half, because he was such a good friend of Kalidasa. He knows the ins and outs of Kalidasa. So, Mahisham cha sarat chandra chandrika adavalam dahi. There are 16 letters here in the second half. I am not giving any, Bhojaraja says, I am not giving anything for the first half, but for the second half, for each syllable there, I am giving you a lakh. So 16 lakhs of currency they got for this shloka. It's a beautiful one. Now I will go to the, so you can see what I mean by my tidbits from my tradition. The next one, number 4. This is a shloka with a Ramayana background. The king Ram, Lord Rama, has come back after 14 years of exile from to the forest and everything. You know all that. Sita has been abducted, carried away, and Ravana has been chased and killed with a fight and so on. So they have all come back. What does Rama do? when they come back and meet everybody in Bharata's Nandika, that Nandigrama ashrama, all the king, I mean the queens, the three queens, and everybody was there, all the courtiers, they are all there, ministers, everybody. So he makes pranam, he makes prostrations. I mean, as Ram is the, usually has great respect for the elders and the gurus, Vasishta, Vamadeva, like that. So he makes pranam to everybody. Naturally, he makes a pranam to Queen Kaikeyi also. But Kaikeyi is really ashamed, because she was the one who plotted the whole thing and sent him to the forest. So she's a little, why little? She was very apologetic, and so prevented Ram prostrating before her. But Ram said, no, no, no. This sloka. So this is a composition by somebody, but this sloka contains beautiful statements from Ram. Tatasneho Bharatamahima Paurusham Vaisuno Sita Satyam Nijabujabalam Vairinam Vairi Bhavaham Sakyam Chopi Pravakadipate Raktasendrasya Bhaktihi Jnatam Sarvam Tavacharanayor Mataresha Prasadaha. Tatasneho, he says, the how much can a father love the son? Tatasneha. You see, in the world we have heard about fathers and sons. Which father laid off his whole life at the departure of the son? Tatasneha. So he ends up by saying, Rama ends up, Jnatam Sarvam Tava Charanayor Mataresha Prasadaha. O mother, it is all your prasada. It is because of you, Jnatam Sarvam Tava Charanayor Prasadaha. The grace of your feet. That is why I am prostrating to you. I came to know of how much my father loved me. Tatasneha. So like that he lists Bharata Mahima. Certainly. The greatness of Bharata. I mean, in fact, Bharata's greatness even excels Rama's in the Ramayana. Tatasneha Bharata Mahima Paurusham Vayusuna. The Hana Vayusuna, the son of the wind god Vayu, Hanuman. His strength, his valor, his greatness, Paurusham, right? Vayusuno, that also was learned. So, Tatasnegaha, Jnatam, Bharata Mahima, Jnatam, everything we owe it to you. Because of you, we came to know, not only I came to know, the world came to know all these things. Sita Satyam, look at the steadfastness to truth of Sita. Nija Bhuja Balam. I did not know that I had so much power in me. Nija Bhuja Balam. My own strength. I came to know. Jnatam Sarvam. I got to know of it. All of this because of your grace of your feet. Sakyam Chapit Plavakandrupate. Plavakandrupati. Plavaka is monkey. The monkey, the king of the monkeys, king of the vanaras, who is that? Sugriva. His friendship. See how he held on to my friendship. Even at the greatest moment of depression. Sakyam chapi plavakadrupadehe rakshasendrasya bhakti. One more. Vibhishana rakshasendra. His bhakti. You see, his bhakti. Even to the what appeared to be an enemy to his brother, he was prepared to forsake his brother and showed his bhakti, his love, his loyalty to me. So Tata Snehaka was known, Bharata Mahima was known, Vaisuno of Paurusham was known, Nijabuja Balam was known, Sita Satyam was known, Vairinam Vairivabaha. Our enemies, how much enmity they had to me, for me. This was known by you, Yatam Sarvam. All these things were known. Tava Charanayoho Mataresha Prasadaha. This sloka is a composition by one of the Vanaras. It appears, we don't know, I don't have a proper authority for this. I have heard it said that the Vanaras, when they were finally having a great dinner in Rama's palace, Ayodhya, and under Bharata's leadership, they were all jumping and vying with one another to recite a sloka in continuation, as a recital of the entire story of the Ramayana. So one of the Vanaras did this sloka. Tata Sneho Bharata Mahima Paurusham Vayusuno Jnatam Sarvam Tava Charanayoho Mataresha Prasadaha. I'll go to the next one now. What is the next one? Kamboje. Okay. Kamboje Pariniyatam Pashupatim. Kamboje Pariniyatam Pashupatim Dhanyasihe Parvati Yachantam Kalimohanam Shivakaram Prapta Swayam Bhairavi Anandena Chashankara Varanatam Aptaschane me jana yam tva rajya kamashugam varamataha saurashtrike tvam bhaje. This is an ordinary prayer sloka to Mother Goddess Parvati. Kamboje, in the Assam region, she married Pashupati. Oh, what a blessing, Dhanya. You got a great blessing. Yachantam Kalimohanam Shivakaram Prapta Swayam Bhairavi. His the Lord's hand, so many people were asking, but she got it. Prapta Swayam Bhairavi Anandena Cha Shankarabharanatam. So she became a great ornament to the Lord Himself. Shankarabharanatam Aptascha Neme Jana. So many other people could not get that. Tvaradhya kamashukam. If I propitiate you, I get whatever I want very soon. Ashu. Ashugam varamataha. Saurashtrike tvambaje. So this is a simple prayer shloka. But the beauty of it is, there are 8 Carnatic musical ragas named here. Kamboje, that is Kambodhi. Pariniyatam Pashupatim Dhanyasi, Dhanya, Dhanyasi. Yachantam Kalimo Mohanam. Shivakaram Prapta Swayam Bhairavi. So, Kambodhi, Dhanyasi, Mohanam, Bhairavi. Ananda, so Ananda Bhairavi. Shankarabharanatam, Shankarabharanam. Aptaschane me janaha. Yantvaradhya kamashugam. Kam Ashu, that is the may a word here for the prayer purpose, but Kamashu, Kamas is a raga. And Saurashtrika, Saurashtra raga. Saurashtrike, the name of the goddess, but here it also represents a raga, Saurashtrike. So 8 ragas are mentioned here. This is an interesting shloka that I keep remembering. I'll go to the next one now. Okay, Kamboje Pariniyatam Tatasneho. There are 6th one. Yadasya Charanam Dhruvasya Vayaha Vidya Gajendrasya Kam. This shloka is also in the tradition. I don't know who made this. Bhaktya Tushyati Kevalam. Natu Gunai Bhakti Priya Shripatihi. This is actually a shloka which I heard GNB singing once upon a time. That is in the 40s and 50s, I think. GNB was a great Carnatic exponent, music exponent, GN Balasubramanian. So this shloka, he used to sing this in an enchanting fashion that you cannot forget it ever. I have not forgotten it. Bhaktya tushyati kevalam nati gunaihi bhakti priya shripatihi. The Lord Vishnu, he is a lover of bhakti. He is satisfied only by bhakti, not by anything else. Look at this. Vyadasya acharanam, the great Vyasa, spoken of in Mahabharata. You see, he did not have a great ethics. He was a meat eater, he was a butcher, so many things. But he was able to even teach great things, and he was a great bhakta. He was a great devotee of the Lord. Vyadhasya acharanam. Where was his? Dhruvasya cha vayaha. What age? So age does not give you the Lord's grace. Age is not important. Dhruvasya cha vayaha. Where was the age of Dhruva? He was a little boy. Vidya Gajendrasya ka. What education did Gajendra have? Ka jatihi vidurasya. Vidura was not, belonged to the so-called lower caste, Vidura, in Mahabharata. Yadava patehe ugrasya kimpaurusham. Ugrasena, the father of Vasudeva in the Bhagavatam, he was almost a coward. So, how was he benefited by the grace of the Lord? So, no, Paurusha, the great valor, that is not important. Kubjaya kamaniya rupam adhikam. Kubja, the who was a hunchback, that lady, she was blessed by the Lord. But what kind of good rupa? So, all even good form. Form is not necessary. Ethics is not the important thing. Age is not the important thing. Vidya, the education is not the important thing. Jati, caste is not the important thing. Paurusha, one's valor is not the important thing. Form, beauty of form is not important. Kimtat sudhamno dhanam. Kimtat sudhamno dhanam. Sudhama, the one who is also known as Kuchela, he did not have wealth. So even wealth is not the one which pleases the Lord. What pleases the Lord? Bhaktya tushyati kevalam. Natu gunai, not by any other attribute. He is Bhakti Priya Sripati. A beautiful sloka. Vyadasya macharanam dhruvasya cha vayagam vidya gajendrasya ka. Like this. GNB used to sing this beautifully in an enchanting fashion. That is number 6. The 7 is, let us see, where is the 7? Mandhoto samahi patihi kritayugolankara bhuto gacharam. I am not able to get, it is hidden here. Mandhoto samahi pati kritayugolankara bhuto gacharam seturgena mahotato virachitaham kwaso udashasyam takaram anye chopi. Anyechaapi yudhishthira prabhrutayo yata divam bhupate. Let me see how I get this. I don't know how I get this. This is a shloka which is a beautiful lesson for all of us. It is a beautiful lesson for all of us. Bhojaraja, as a boy, was supposed to be, I mean, he was not at a major one, major. So his uncle, father's brother, took care of him until he came of age. That was the arrangement. But the uncle, was corrupt in the sense that he wanted to appropriate all the wealth and the kingdom that rightfully belongs to Bhoja. So he ordered his head to be cut off, and he had minister obeying his orders, and he took him away to the forest for cutting his head. But the minister finally repented his decision, so he did not cut the little boy's head. So he was going to save him. At that time, the little boy, see, I think 12 years old or 11 years old, little boy wrote a shloka on a leaf by getting his own blood on it, and said, take this shloka to the king. The minister planned to make a replica of the head of the little son, Bhoja, and take it to the king and show it to him, saying that I have killed that little boy. So here is the severed head is here. So he made an impression that he had killed the boy. But the king asked, what did the boy say at the last moment? So the minister produced a piece of leaf on which was written this shloka. I am not able to show you this shloka. I don't know why. Mondhoto samaji patihi krithayu golankar. It's not available here. It is simply hidden itself. Okay. Aribai in the Kirtan. So the shloka says four lines. First line it says, Mandata Samahipati Kritayugalankara Bhuto Gata. In Kritayuga, the great Mandata king was there, world famous king. Where is he gone? He is gone. He is no more. Seturiena Mahodata Virachita Kwasau Dashasyantaka. The Lord made the great Setu, Rama Setu, bridge. He killed Ravana, such a great Lord. Where is he now? He is not here. He is gone. Anyechapi Yudhishthira Prabhuteha Yata Divambhupate. There are many others like Yudhishthira or the Mahabharata. They are also gone. He is also gone. None of them took the world, the earth with them. Maybe, surely, you will take it with you. That's it. This shloka simply cut the king to the quick. Oh, he repented very much and went on wailing about his sinful act. And of course, finally, everything came to light by the minister telling him the real truth that Bhoja was alive. So these are the seven shlokas that I very much wanted to share with you. They all belong to our Sanatana tradition. Anyway, thank you for giving me this opportunity to share with you these seven shlokas. Swasti prajabhyat paripalayantam yayena margena mahim mahisha gobrahmanebhyah shubhamastu nityam lokah samastah sukhino bhavantu.